Good afternoon. At least it's afternoon here in the Eastern Time Zone in the United States. I'm Biff Mixalot. I am here with Wreck-It Ray and Snarlet Fever. And we're bringing you game number two of Sunday's action at Birthday Bash from State College, Pennsylvania, brought to you by State College Area Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, broadcasting. The second game is going to see a matchup between Steel City Roller Derby from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Philly Roller Derby from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And now let's meet the Steel City roster. They got here by losing last night to Queen City from Buffalo, New York, by a score of 142 to 123. Steel City led that game at halftime. So we'll meet the Steel City Skaters. It's number 1028, Eva Destruction. Number 118, Helga G. Pesmaki. Number 12, Zora. Number 129, Number 13, Courtney Karsmashian. Number 16, Dodge and Burn. Number 17, Yinzi Lohan. Number 2, Stark Raven. Number 209, Fanny Junk Cannon. Number 219, Dakota Slamming. Number 23, Tawanda Woman. Number 25, Allie McKill. Number 26, Strange. Number 31, Jinxie Jackal. Number 462, Scary Jane. Number 67, Mad. Number 8, Venus Thytrap. Number 800, Terminate Her. Number 88, Flux. And number 925, Dolly Farton. Bench coaching for Steel City this afternoon is Weird Al Slap-A-Bench. And now Wreck-It Ray is going to give us Philly Roller Derby.
Yep, and we have Philly Roller Derby here. Yesterday, it looks like they lost to Gem City. Philly scoring 120, Gem City 194. And so starting out, we have number 0, Anya Arson, 100, Antidote. 1200, Liberty Violence. 2, Broccoli Shenanigans. 22, Arcana Tarot. 23, Shreddy Vetter. 253, Fury. 29, Steph Leopard. Number 30, Zirkle. 311, Thigh Jinx. 32, Baroness de Menace. 324, Sherman Tank. 37, Red Velvet. 51, Cass Warfare. 750, Whiskey Chaser. 88, Riptide. 902, Rousey. 99, Russian Bayou. 999, Hush Money. And being met with our coaches, Double H, Basie Lords, and Estee Slaughter.
So, hey, we get a little bit of a pop of color in this game. Steel City will be wearing the yellow uniform, yellow jerseys, Philly in blue. Seen an awful lot of black and white so far this weekend.
Sorry, everyone.
So, we are about a minute and a half away from action. Our first game saw Dutchland defeat Ithaca League of Women Rollers 162 to 103, I believe. So they get third place in the B bracket. This game is for third place in the A bracket and probably some bragging rights within the state of Pennsylvania. These are two of the probably the longest established derby leagues. We'll see how they've come out of 2 years, a lengthy layoff, both in experience and fitness level here.
Yeah, it looks like Philly's on the track, ready to go already.
It's like everybody's up and around. We got the crowd filling in nicely here. It's a little sparse for the first game of the day at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Here's Steel City in their bright yellow. Hard to miss.
Bright yellow.
Also, that ref is hard to miss with their yellow smiley faces on their helmet and vest.
I I did see one of the Philly bench coaches was wearing a pink and a white striped onesie.
Oh, maybe we'll get a camera pan and we can see that.
Yeah, I think I caught that a few seconds ago, but.
Looks like everybody's ready to go, just waiting on that on that whistle.
All right.
There it is.
All right.
Stay there for now.
First jam of the game. It'll be Zora jamming for Steel City against Shreddy Vedder of Philly. First jam of the game is underway of game two. And Zora little toe stop through the tulips around the outside. Picks up lead for Steel City. Shreddy Vedder still stuck in the pack for Philly. Zora quickly around on a scoring pass. She meets a tripod of Philly blockers at the rear of the pack.
Pack is spread out pretty thin. Looks like Shreddy's getting pulled all the way back, but it's being called off. That.
Zora able to pick up the first 2 points of the game for Steel City. Tawanda Woman, the jam for Steel City against Antidote of Philly. Antidote quickly through and lead jammer for Philly.
Tawanda's right Philly's first behind them.
Yeah. Pack moving at a very high rate of speed. So Antidote calls the jam, picks up 1 point. And keeps Steel City off the board. It's still, it score stands at 2-1 in favor of Steel City.
Sorry, I was trying.
Granted, it's only, 2.5 minutes into the game, but so far, nobody in the box.
Oh, I know.
Yeah. Flex for Steel City and Steph Leppard for Philly. Pile up, and Steph Leppard takes off, but looks like has a cut track penalty. Power jam for Steel here.
Flux can get out of the pack. And Flux spins out, picks up a lead. Pack is set up in turn two. Flux on a scoring pass. That's four
easy
quick
peasy
points for Steel City. Yeah. Blockers reorganize. Flux is in on a second scoring pass. Spins to the inside. Dropped in the infield. Has to draw back. Penalty to Steph Leppard has expired. Packs break apart in the back straightaway. Steph Leppard is through.
Fading initial pass, putting that star back on, and Flux is going to call that before Philly can get any points.
And Flux able to collect 2 additional points. That'll extend Steel City's lead to 8-1. And Zora back to the jammer line already against Rousey. Rousey is out and lead jammer for Philly.
Zora makes their way through the pack.
Rousey, the apex jump, didn't quite land it. And she'll call the jam as Zora approached the pack rather quickly.
No points for anyone, though.
Tawanda Woman, the jammer now for Steel City. And Shreddy Vetter, the jammer for Philly.
And Tawanda hopping around and making it out for the lead.
That was a nice evasive maneuver by Tawanda Woman around the last Philly blocker. I think that was Zirkel at the front of the pack. Tawanda Woman.
Their initial pass.
And Tawanda Woman picks up 4 points, calls the jam.
Holding Philly at 1 point still.
And we have a team timeout taken by Philly. And we're waiting to see what... they've requested an official review, it appears.
Okay. We'll be interested to hear what that's for.
So we got representatives from both teams now out there discussing that with the referee.
I do love that rainbow tutu out there.
Yeah, it definitely seems like we brought out the festive apparel here on Sunday. And I think it looks like all the Philly bench staff is wearing a onesie of some sort. And we got the tutu there on the other side. But this event is part of WFTDA's 2022 Back on Track Global Event Series. Celebration of the reemergence of our sport by showcasing roller derby events of all kinds happening around the world for the rest of the year. See our list of events at WFTDA.com/backontrack. And next weekend, we'll be bringing you some games from the tournament hosted by Steel City, the Flavortown Throwdown. I believe that's all on Saturday, if I read the schedule correctly.
And also next weekend, Arizona Roller Derby is hosting Cactus Cup. I believe that's next weekend.
So through our back channel, we've learned that the official review was looking for a track cut penalty to be assessed. It was determined there was not enough evidence to corroborate that. So Philly does not retain their official review. Eddie Doat jamming for Philly against Flux. And Flux is through and lead for Steel City.
Looks like Antidote took off the star and then decided to put the star back on.
In the meantime, Flux is through for 4 points.
Antidote is out.
It looked like she was awarded lead there. I'm trying to figure out what may have happened.
I think they blew the whistle. I don't know that the jam ref understood if lead was open or not. Sometimes that communication can get a little muddled.
But in any case, Steel City. Yeah. Looks like we got some huddling there in the middle. In any case, Steel City back ahead to 16-1.
Wonder if they're going to call an official timeout and fix that time. So if that, yeah, it looks like if there was a communication error and Philly was given lead and was allowed to call it off, then that's going to be a jammer penalty or captain. So I don't remember that far, but not exactly sure that's what happened.
Well, there's. Yeah, that would be a penalty to the jammer, but I think the referee that awarded it would probably have some penance to do after the game with the other referees.
Yeah, have a chat.
Yeah.
Beating out in the parking lot.
But it looks like you've got both jammers on the line.
Steel City, looks like a 4-on-3 pack advantage to start this jam. Zora the jammer for Steel City. Philly gets lead.
And that's what, 9:02? Rousey? Yeah.
Yes. Rousey with lead. Rousey's picked up 4 points. Calls the jam.
All right. And that's the first points. No. Nope. Did not call the jam. Got a penalty.
There we go. Power jam now to Steel City. I mean, it looked like Rousey was trying to call off the jam there. I'm not quite sure what happened. Didn't see the penalty signal right away.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to look for. It's a nice offense for Zora, but got stuck on the inside. Rousey back on the track. See if she can get those points again. There we go.
Zora's still first stuck in the pack.
Yeah, first points for Philly in a hot minute.
Since jam two.
Yeah.
Well, neither jammer with lead, so this is going to go 2 minutes. Rousey. Easily to the inside. It was like she had the cloak of invisibility. Everybody, all the blockers were concerned with Zora. And Rousey's just cruising around the inside, picking up points. And that's the biggest jam of the game for Philly. They've cut the lead pretty much in half. Zora was able to collect a total of 7. Yeah.
Yeah, 15 for Philly. Nice jam.
It's pretty much been feast or famine for Philly for the first 7 jams here.
Let's hope they keep this momentum going.
So we got an old school pivot line start.
There we go. Steph Leppard out lead for Philly.
Steph Leppard with lead. Steph Leppard around on a scoring pass.
Tawanda fighting with those Philly blockers still.
Steph Leppard taking time out of her jamming to put a block in on Tawanda Woman. Everybody's locked up in turn two. Tawanda Woman shakes loose, completing her initial pass. Steph Leppard calls the jam. And collects a full 4 points on that pass. Steel City now leads by 27-20.
Close that gap up real fast.
And 19 points the last two jams for Philly. cut the Steel City lead to single digits. Shreddy Vetter the jammer against Flux. Nice team effort there by Steel City to bounce out Shreddy Vetter. Flux dealing with a full complement of Philly blockers at the front. Trying to back her way out. Stretching the pack to its breaking point. And Flux is through and lead jammer for Steel City.
Shreddy gets out just as Flux comes around and snags some points. Oh, beautiful hop and evasive there.
That was a much easier pass than the first pass for Flux.
Yeah. Like Shreddy's going to be able to get some points, hopefully.
That action comes to a standstill in the back straightaway. Shreddy is out. 4 points for Philly.
Looks like we got the Philly pivot heading to the box.
Flux completes a second scoring pass.
Yep. I wasn't quite able to get through as easily that time.
But Shreddy Vetter still stuck in the pack. Two Steel City blockers going to have her on lockdown. Flux is Sue for a third 4 points. That's 12. Shreddy Vetter so far with 8. Flux.
Oh.
A failed apex jump.
Shut
Did she
out.
Get any points before that? So no additional points, it appears, for Steel City. Shreddy Vetter picked up an additional 2. I stand corrected. 4 more points for Flux. So Steel City leads now 43-30. Antidote jamming against Zora. Zora through the inside.
Taken off. The Antidote right behind him.
Zora into the pack. A bit of wreckage there in turn 2. Zora calls the jam. It's a 4-2 jam for Steel City. Do I see someone requesting an official review? Guess not. Steph Leppard jamming against Tawanda Woman. And Tawanda Woman forgot the jammer star. Meantime, Steph Leppard picks up a lead. Jam is called. Not sure what transpired there, but...
Yeah, I'm a little confused as well.
Yeah. Yeah, Steph Leppard had the lead. Tawanda Woman was dealing with the helmet cover. And I think that's what might be... That might be an issue prompting the official timeout.
Yeah, I don't... They may have changed it, but last I remember, if you started without a star on and you have a jammer available to be out on the track, it would be a false start and have to reset.
So we have two old school teams, and we have an old school pivot line start where all the blockers are gathered. Jammers Ooh. Run up. Rousey
making quick work of that outside.
Rousey is lead. Terminator, new jammer for Steel City. Stuck in the pack, Rousey collects a quick 4 points.
Terminate her, getting that inside line cleared open by their blockers, and just went for it. Zout.
Rousey into the pack. Calls the jam. How many additional points did Rousey get?
Another four. A four.
All right. So an 8-0 jam now for Philly. Steel City with a 6-point lead. Halfway through the first period. Shreddy Vedder jamming against Zora. And Zora is through and lead jammer for Steel City.
Got a forearm penalty on a Steel City blocker for 31.
And if you blinked, you missed that scoring pass there by Zora. She's quickly around and through for 4 points. Not
almost
quite as successful in her second pass.
Yeah.
And Zora's recycled to the inside and drawn back. And Zora around.
It's like Shreddy's finally out on their initial pass, and get that jam ended, and 8-0. Steel City trying to put some more room in that lead.
Well, Zora's been very productive in her few jams on the track so far. Zora jammed 13. We have 13:38 left in the first period. Antidote jamming against Tawanda Woman. Tawanda Woman almost out of the pack. She's brought back in by the Philly pivot.
Antidote just trying to push those Steel City blockers out. Looks like some reinforcements are coming in. Star off and a star pass.
In the meantime, Tawanda Woman got lead. Booty blocked the outside there. And Tawanda Woman finding a path to the outside, collects 4 points.
And I think, yeah, it looks like there was the star pass to Liberty Violence, but then I believe Liberty Violence landed in the box. Power jam for Steel City.
Yep. Tawanda Woman with 4 points already on the power jam. Pack locks down in the back straightaway.
Quick work of those Philly blockers. They real quick to move back up to the front and try to cover Tawanda from escaping the pack. Good time filler. Liberty Violence out of the box now. Steel City trying to call it off. There we go.
Tawanda Woman, it looks like for about a good 5 seconds, was trying to call the jam. I'm not sure if they just didn't see it or quite what the issue was there.
I saw it.
But in any case, 7 points for Steel City, no points for Philly. Steel City's lead is back out to 21 points at 62-41. Steph Leopard quickly around the outside and lead. Now she got a running start up to the jammer line and was able to just hop around on her toe stops to pick up lead status for Philly. And she's through.
And getting scores. There's four. Like Flux finally out.
Steph Leopard threw for a second scoring pass already. And I think Steph Leopard heard the instructions from her bench to call it. That's a 6-0 jam for Philly.
It looks like a Steel City's pivot got out of the box, came in, and went back to the box.
Imagine she'll be on a first name basis with the penalty trackers there. Zora jamming against Rousey. Rousey wasting no time getting out of the pack. She is lead for Philly.
Zora's sure in hot pursuit. Like, toe stop hopped through all of the skaters through the middle.
And Zora with the, Rousey with the apex jump calls off the jam very quickly. 3-0 for Philly. They trail now 62-50. WFTDI Wellness is excited for our community. Together, we are creating a vibrant community for healing, connection, and support in roller derby. Learn more at WFTDI.com.
Steel City taking a timeout.
So it looked like the first few jams Steel City might run away with this, but this is turning into a nice, close, competitive game. I think both teams have had their little runs, and so Philly back to within 12 points here, thanks to Rousey.
Yeah, fun game today.
Two fun games so far, and hopefully have more later. At 2 o'clock, we have Rock City from Rochester, New York against the home team, State College Area Roller Derby. Followed up by Queen City and Gem City, who won their first games yesterday. Okay, we're almost ready to get back. Shreddy Vetter against Tawanda Woman.
Tawanda just taking those toe stops on that outside line, beautifully getting lead. Steel City pivot out of the box.
Shreddy Vetter has completed her initial pass.
Wanda calling it before Shreddy can get any points on the board. Meanwhile, picking it free for Steel City.
So less than 9 minutes remaining in the half. Skaters regrouping here. We have Flux jamming against Antidote.
And this first half has gone by pretty fast. There goes Flux. Nagged lead. Looks like Antidote has their star off. Not sure if they're going to complete a pass or not. Looks like the pivot does have the star. That's Baroness Menace. Completing initial pass, trying to. Flux just stuck on the back with those Philly blockers.
Baroness de Menace finally shaking loose from the pack there. Completing her initial pass. Flux sees that, calls off the jam.
Holding Philly scoreless for two or three jams now?
Yeah.
Two.
So Steel City back out to an 18-point lead. And Philly will call the team timeout. All right, team timeout taken by
I do love the onesies. They look super comfortable.
I wish I had one.
I mean, I'm in Phoenix, so I wish I had one that just didn't, like, make me gross.
One, maybe one that's air conditioned.
Yeah.
So far, both teams have roughly an equal number of jams with no picking up no score, which is a little surprising. It seems like Steel City has had, perceptually, they've had few of those, but they have the same number as Philly.
Hey, it looks like we're about to get that whistle to get this next jam started. Looks like a 3-3 pack.
Do we have an earthquake in State College right now? Rousey jamming against Zora. Rousey is new jammer for Philly.
Yeah, losing no time getting out of that pack and snagging lead.
Zora is out as well. So the pack is stopped at turns one and two. Zora spins into the packs, gets through. Rousey elects not to call that. Yeah. Rousey elected not to call that jam, but Philly still comes out ahead 8-2. Six and a half minutes left in the half.
Looks like Steel City might be starting a little short this jam.
So Shreddy Vedder jamming against Tawanda Woman. Tawanda Woman with lead. But has to recycle. Philly managed to draw her out of the draw her off the track.
Oh man! That is the worst. To be like, I did it, I got out, and then I got doing it again without points.
The very last second, get dragged out again.
You know, at the same time, it's a good time killer. Steel City is trying to hold that lead.
Yeah, Steel City has Shreddy Vedder pretty well contained. I mean, so Tawanda Woman's struggles are not quite so bad for them.
Looks like Philly has Tawanda on lock now.
Jammers are going nowhere right now. This is all about the blockers at this particular moment. Philly trying to draw a track cut, but Tawanda Woman. Scoreless jam
no.
For both teams. Yeah. Time to regroup.
Yeah. Looks like we got full packs now.
Steph Leppard jamming against Flux.
Leopard trying to hit in between and move around and
Steph Leopard able to Steph Leopard is able to kind of crowbar the tripod apart there for Philly to get lead.
Looks like Flex has taken the star off. No complete pass yet.
It's Steph Leppard in the pack on a scoring run. She is through. That's four big points for Philly.
It looks like Flex is going to the box. Looks like a back block. I believe what I saw was some tiptoes on the outside line and landed on another skater. A power jam for Philly with lead.
So Philly maybe getting the chance to end the half on a power jam. They've narrowed the gap to 6 points. Steph Leppard with eight so far.
Beautiful job by Philly's blockers to get that pack broken apart so Steph can just slide on through. Flex back on the track. Little hoppity hop from Steph Leppard. Completing another scoring pass. This should take them over to lead. There we go.
And we have a lead change.
And a big celebratory hug. We've got an official review. Your official review from Steel City. I am willing to bet it is to challenge the back block call on that jammer.
That would make sense. So Philly, you know, spotted Steel City a pretty decent sized lead early. They've come all the way back to take the lead on that 16-point jam.
That was a beautiful jam by Philly.
And they held Steel to no points.
Which is something. I know the Philly blockers really made it easy for the jammer to get through on the offense, making sure they're taking their time on the jammer to make sure, you know, we hold them scoreless. Let's get back in the lead. Let's make some paths. So it looks like yellow. Steel City is looking for a high block on the Philly jammer. Don't know that I saw that, but we will see how that turns out. Got the tutus and the onesies out there talking about it. And it looks like the official review was not retained. So, no high block call on the Philly jammer.
Yeah, we see two full sets of skaters on the track. And Rousey jamming once again against Zora.
And out and Rousey.
Zora's off in hot pursuit. Blockers reorganize in turns one and two. Rousey quickly through the pack, calls the jam.
Not before Steel City Zora snags a couple points, yeah. I believe.
Yeah, did she keep Zora off the scoreboard? She did not. So Zora able to steal two before the fourth whistle. 78-74 in favor of Philly. Less than 2 minutes remaining in the half. This could possibly be the last jam of the half. Tawanda Woman jamming against Antidote. Antidote forced up to the outside.
Like a Steel City going to the box for multiplayer. Antidote is out, but not lead as there was a no pass, no penalty.
And Dakota Slamming getting the star pass.
This will be the final jam of the half. There's no lead.
So this is going to go two full minutes. The last jam of the half.
And collecting another 4 points. Yeah, second scoring pass. Meanwhile, I think Steel City is still, Dakota Slamming still on the first scoring pass. Ooh, big spill on Antidote there. This Philly blocker is holding Dakota Slamming down. It looks like the Steel City blockers are hitting out Antidote and pulling them all the way back every chance they can get.
Meantime, Dakota Slamming really kind of struggling with the front of the pack here.
We can get some offense help in here. There we go.
Tawanda Woman throwing the nice block there to get Dakota Slamming loose.
Antidote out for a third scoring pass.
Dakota Slamming, trying to split the last two Philly blockers, does so. She picks up a total of 8 points. 12 points to Philly. So that'll end the half with Philly Roller Derby leading Steel City by a score of 90-82.
Yeah, Philly really came in and got those points, and they were starting to get real low, and Steel City was trying to run off with it, and Philly was like, nah, not that easy.
Yeah, Rousey kind of came in as a jammer and was scoring points in bunches there for Philly. Steel City maybe tried to neutralize that by pairing Zora against her, but it wasn't very effective at times.
Rousey's so, gotten anyway, lead every time she's been out.
Yeah. I was going to ask if the percentage of Rousey was a lead jam. I'm pretty sure every time she's on that track, she takes it.
Yep.
That's wonderful.
So in any case, Philly comes away with the lead, 90-82. And you got two teams that want to end this weekend with a victory, having lost their first games yesterday. So, in any case, we're going to take a little break and get back at you here in about 12 or 13 minutes. See you later. Okay. Good afternoon. We are back. Just about to get this second half underway here at the Birthday Bash in State College, Pennsylvania. I'm Biff Mix-a-Lot. I'm here with Wreck-It Ray and Snarlet Fever. And we're ready to go into half number two of our second game of the day between Steel City Roller Derby from Pittsburgh, Philly Roller Derby from Philadelphia. Bragging rights for the state of Pennsylvania on the line here in this game. This is the third place game of Bracket A of Birthday Bash. And Philly leads by a score of 90-82.
Yeah, it's been quite the game so far. Steel City held Philly really low for a long time. And then Philly just kind of came in and stacked up those points slowly and surely over time. And then there was a couple really big point jams.
Yeah, Rousey came in, did a really nice job as jammer. I think she was 100% earning lead status for Philly.
Yep.
Both teams came into this game. They lost their first games yesterday. They both want to get out of here with a win. And Steel City gets to move on next week to Flavortown Throwdown that they are hosting. And that will be broadcast here on Twitch.
So there's a lot of derby happening.
Yeah, next week especially. Yeah. No matter what time zone you're there, matter what, exactly, finally. And no matter what time zone you're in, you'll have something to watch, I'm sure. So we're ready to go. Rousey will be first to put on the jammer star for Philly this half against Zora for Steel City. A very familiar jammer pair in here. And the second half is underway.
And I think this is Rousey. The longest that Steel City's held back Rousey.
Yeah, and Rousey's back behind the jammer line. Zora stretched the pack to its breaking point, picks up lead. First lead of the second half for Steel City. And Zora is quickly around on a scoring pass. And pretty easily through the pack. That's four quick points for Steel City.
Rousey just making it out.
Zora spins into the pack, calls the jam. Picks up three additional points. And all of a sudden, we have a one-point game. Philly 90, Steel City 89. So ready to start jam number two.
Got Shreddy Vedder and Tawanda out there. Last time Shreddy was on the track as a jammer is when she snagged 16 points.
That sounds right. But Tawanda Woman quickly out, lead jammer for Steel City. And Steel City, 2-for-2, earning lead status so far in the half. Philly loses a blocker to the penalty box. Tawanda Woman picks up a track cut. I think she stuck a wheel out in the ref lane while she was hopping around the pack. That's going to give Shreddy Vedder a power jam.
They're trying to keep it slow, but she's keeping her feet moving, making a move. Looks like the Steel City pivot is off to the box, and Shreddy making it out finally.
Yeah, that was her initial pass. And that took probably the better part of the penalty time to Tawanda Woman.
Ooh, made it through, though.
Nope. Must have dragged something through the infield.
Sad. And
the penalty to Tawanda Woman has expired. This jam will go 2 full minutes since neither jammer has lead. And Shreddy Vedder finally gets out as the jam.
Philly holding that lead by 2 points right now. Looks like Steel City picked up 3 and Philly picked up 4.
That was a lot of work for a 4-3 jam.
It was.
But we have a 2-point game.
Full packs. Steph Flux, Leopard and Flux.
Flux got a running start up to the jam line. She has lowered the shoulder into the tripod of Philly blockers, trying to pry them apart. Ooh. Steph Leopard bottled up at the rear of the pack. She was able to break apart. It's like we lose a Philly blocker here.
Looks like Flux had hit out Steph Leopard, trying to get her reabsorbed into the pack, but it doesn't work. Okay.
Neither jammer has lead. And Flux finally gains lead for Steel City. Took just over a minute. Steph Leopard out in hot pursuit.
Yeah, that was the initial pass for both.
Flux calls the jam.
Like a special reveal. Yeah, that's the hard part about being a ref, is there's a lot to look at. There's a lot to see what's going on, especially when there's 10 bodies on the floor.
Plus 7 officials.
Yeah. I cannot tell you how many times I've almost been run over by a skating official as a non-skating official.
So Philly loses the official review.
It looks like our normal Zora versus Rousey.
Jam is underway.
And they've got a direction of gameplay penalty on there we go.
Man, Rousey.
I saw that.
Yeah, Rousey emerged from the scrum, picked up lead, got 4 quick points, called the jam as Zora was approaching the pack. So Philly extends their lead to 98-92. So blockers massed around the pivot line to start with. Jam starts or not.
No. Timeout.
An official timeout.
We had a ref exit the track and return.
We'll find out who the jammers are here momentarily.
Have
it's like Terminator. Against Antidote.
Like Terminator stuck in that whole tripod of skaters pushing through, trying to. And Steel City just keeps recycling Antidote to the back.
Yeah. 40 seconds in, no lead jammer. And Antidote picks up a track cut penalty. So Terminator will have the opportunity for a power jam if she can shake loose from the pack here. And she does.
With
lead jammer to Steel City. So Steel City working with a 6-point deficit on the power jam. Terminator into the pack.
Steel City blockers trying to make some offense, but didn't do as well. Still killed some time as Antidote returns to the track.
And Antidote completes her initial pass. Terminator will call the jam as Antidote circulates around. But's able to collect 4 points for Steel City. Now a two-point game, 98-96.
It's really hard to try and figure out who's going to take the win today. But also, it's really cool seeing that two home state teams, you know, are so close in gameplay.
Yeah, we have Tawanda Woman jamming against Steph Leopard.
Steph Leopard making it out of that outside line.
She knew exactly where her toe stops were. Tawanda Woman out in hot pursuit.
Beautiful dodge and evade by Steph Leopard there. Just as the Steel City Jammer hits that back wall. Billy has hit the century mark, 102-96. Just kidding, 102-98.
To Wanda Woman, able to steal a couple of points right at the end of that jam. And we get Flux jamming against Rousey. So maybe Steel City altering their jammer rotation a little bit. Rousey is out in lead. Flux right on her tail.
Pat can't decide if they want to speed up or slow down.
But I think you have two teams maybe with differing agendas on that front. Depending on who has lead or not. But Flux able to collect 2 points. As does Rousey.
That's great.
So we are at 104-100 in favor of Philly. Less than 20 minutes left in the game. Zora's a gem now against Rousey.
Rousey back on the track. Rousey's like, no, I wasn't done. I want more.
But Rousey gets out and gets lead again. Philly says, hey, we see what you're trying to do here, Steel City. We're not gonna tolerate it.
Yeah.
Rousey. Into the pack. Did Zora steal some points? She did.
Oh, boy.
And Steel City wins the jam despite not getting lead status. They only trail by 2 points.
Oh, what a fun game.
So close.
It looks like Philly Steel City's taking a team timeout.
I thought I saw a Philly skater signaling for one, too, but...
I don't know. Maybe they were just trying to, like, help with communication. Well, not recommended because it can get you in trouble.
So we're getting a live shot of the dais. So we got a crowd filtering in here for the second game of the day. Everybody's been to brunch. Everybody's ready for a full afternoon of derby.
Yeah, it looks like a pretty decent crowd out there.
So Tawanda Woman is jam against Shreddy Vetter. And Tawanda Woman finds a path to the outside. Lead jammer for Steel City. Shreddy Vetter bottled.
Coming in.
I think I see an attempted star pass happening. And while that's going on, Tawanda Woman just cruises around the outside, picks up 4 points. This holds. Beautiful. There will be a lead change.
And again, beautiful footwork on that outside line by Tawanda.
8 points so far in the jam for Steel City. Shreddy Vetter, helmet cover in hand.
Looks like those Philly blockers caught on to Tawanda's shenanigans.
And Shreddy Vetter out of the pack. Allie McKill returns from the penalty box.
And Tawanda saying
point
no.
For.
One more points for Philly.
And we have a lead change. Steel City now back ahead, 113 to 106. An official timeout.
Official review for Steel City. See if we can find out what that's about here in a moment. Like you can see one of the teams in the back there doing some off-skate warm-up.
Steel City joining in. Yeah, I can't hear that there's a DJ on the premises, but somebody's dancing to something.
Everybody's happy about it. All right, so it looks like Steel City is requesting a cut track penalty on the Philly Jammer. Fortunately, I did not see, so I can't say, but looks like the refs and officials are discussing to see what everybody else saw, and we'll let you know as soon as we do. Oh, and looks like it's back.
I think we need the People's Court theme music to overlay in situations like this. Dun, dun, dun.
And it looks like Steel City is not going to be retaining their review. Looks like not enough eyes were on or cut track did not happen. But so it looks like all of both jammers will be on the track. Getting back to it soon.
So I think we've got Steph Leopard coming to the jammer line for Philly against Terminate Her.
Pretty scrummy start up there.
Terminate Her with the most forward progress. Steph Leopard. Nice bit of toe stop work there to try to shake loose. Terminator going shoulder to shoulder with the front of the pack. Keeps the skates moving. Grinding away, gets lead jammer for Steel City.
Meanwhile, Philly lost a blocker to the box. A deficit on their end. Terminator so coming Leopard. Back for scores.
Looks like Steph Leopard tried to throw a block there on Terminate Her. Terminate Her on a scoring pass.
Looks like we got a forearm penalty. Going to another Philly blocker. Oh, that's all
Steph
right.
Leopard.
Oh, Steph Leopard to the box.
So Terminator will call the jam. And Steel City might have a power jam to start this next jam.
Probably for the full 30 seconds. That was called just as the Philly jammer was sitting down.
Smart jammer play there by Terminate Her to call that as soon as she saw the penalty. So Steel City gets the benefit of a power jam start. Tawanda Woman will take the jammer star. Not quite out of the pack.
Direction of gameplay assessed to the Philly pivot, 902.
And we have a Steel City blocker going to the penalty box.
And Steph Leopard's back on. And Tawanda took lead just in time. And looks like another penalty to Steph Leopard. It's like back block penalty assessed.
So the power jam extends for Steel City.
Hearing more
to
whistles.
Wonder Woman.
And another Philly blocker going to the box.
4 points for Tawanda Woman. Back stopped in the back straightaway. Tawanda Woman calls the jam.
That freeze Steph Leopard in the box? Yes, it did.
This is three jams in a row that Steel City has kept Philly from scoring.
Yeah, because they, Philly Jammer got out and then got another penalty and then, you know.
Zora the jammer for Steel City. Zora is lead jammer for Steel City.
Perfect timing because looks like the Philly jammer got out, Steph Leopard, and would have taken that lead right away.
Zora into the pack, completes this on a scoring pass, as is Steph Leopard. But Zora completes the scoring pass, picks up 4 points. Steph Leopard through as well. And Zora picks up another four. Steph Leopard on another scoring pass. Zora. Picks
Zora
up a back
forearm.
Block. Oh, forearm. Maybe got a little bit greedy there on that third scoring pass.
And Steph Leopard's going to have to finish out this jam. With two blockers. Three. There's another one coming up. You can tell Steph Leopard is tired. This is her third jam in a row. 30 seconds left, and Zora's back on the track. Those Philly blockers have her locked down, though. Like we have a multiplayer on a Steel City blocker.
Steph Leopard is out.
Tried to make a little apex hop, but got shut down. And then they were just like, all right, that's cool. I don't want to do it anyways.
So all that being said, a 12-12 jam. Steel City remains ahead by 18 points. 11 and a half minutes left in the game. And then we have an official timeout. Did you know you can broadcast your games without the expense and hassle of traditional streaming? The Remote Studio can get your games to a global audience with as little as a smartphone. No matter your location or budget, get streaming with the Remote Studio. contact broadcast@quadmedia.tv and check out our Broadcasting for Beginners resources at wftda.tv. And we will have a lot for you. We have three more games coming up this afternoon, and we have next weekend coming up games from Pittsburgh, from Cactus Cup, Vienna, and Chile. Follow us on Twitch to be notified when these games go live, and visit wftda.com/backontrack for schedule and event details.
It looks like we're in official timeout still, but it looks like the Blue Jammer, Philly Jammer, may be in the box. Yeah. Boy.
Everybody's happy about something.
I mean, are they happy that the Jammer's on the box again?
Well, I saw Philly joining in there for a second, so maybe...
Maybe there's ice cream outside.
I want ice cream.
I don't know what the weather is in State College, but right here where I'm at in Ohio, it's a little bit chilly for ice cream.
It's never too chilly for ice cream.
Yeah. I agree with that. I remember when I was in Ohio, it completely blew my mind that Dairy Queen closed in the wintertime.
The Dairy Queen in my town's always open. It's the locally owned ice cream shops that close for the winter.
So crazy.
So we got
Flux
Jam against Steph Leppard. Flux is on the power jam for Steel City. So Pack stopped at the pivot line. Flux spinning out.
Beautiful, beautiful footwork all the way around that track.
So four quick points for Flux. Pack stopped in turn two. Flux on a second scoring pass. Forced to recycle. Number 88, Riptide with that drawback.
Looks like we had a Philly star pass to Russian Bayou. And, oh no. Is that another jammer penalty for filling? Oh, is that Flux?
I think Flux picked up the jammer penalty there. She's back out on the track. And maybe it's Russian Bayou sitting in the penalty box right now for Philly.
Well, looks
that's
like
four more points for Flux.
I think it may have been a back-to-back jammer penalty. That's why Russian Bayou went out and got back in so fast. No lead.
This will be a two-minute jam. Russian Bayou's collected 8 points total on this jam as it times out. We'll see what Flux was able to score. She got another three. And two more for Philly. So Steel City remains in the lead, 147 to 128. 9 minutes left in the game.
Let's hope Philly can keep their jammers out of the box. That was a lot of jams in a row of jammer penalties for them.
So it looks like we have the marquee jammer pairing, Zora versus Rousey.
That was super close. Oh boy. All right. Rousey's up ahead of Zora. Zora's hitting that wall and Rousey calls it. Let's see what kind of points everybody picked up here. Two for Philly and two for three for Steel City. 3-2 jam, 150 Steel City to 130 for Philly.
So 8 minutes left in the game. Tawanda Woman to the jammer line against Antidote.
Antidote hitting that pack hard. And taking lead for Philly.
That was a nice, persistent bit of jamming there by Antidote.
Yeah, and Tawanda Woman. After that star pass to Dakota Slamming. Super fast and clean.
I think that was a smart play there by Steel City to try. They knew they were struggling to get Tawanda Woman out of the pack. They handed it off, and they were able to kind of limit the damage that Antidote was able to do. Only a 4-0 jam for Philly. They're still in this game, but the clock is not their friend. Down 16 points with 7 minutes remaining.
It looks like Philly has one time left or one official review left.
Flux jamming against Shreddy Vetter.
Flux almost out, and there we go, out. Star is off of Shreddy Vetter. Might pass it, but hasn't completed one. Flex took an apex jump and landed it, but slid, but still landed it. As long as you get your wheels down first, it counts. Star pass happens there. Menace is out.
But not before Flux can pick up another 4 points for Steel City. 3rd scoring pass for Flux. She is around the outside, but did she pick up a penalty?
Ooh, looks like a track cut
on Flux.
Okay. So it looks like the star cover did not actually make it through. We got Shreddy Vetter still holding the star.
I think the star is still on her helmet. Or not. Yes, it is.
I know.
But it's a power jam for Philly. If Shreddy Vetter can shake loose from the pack.
And Steel City. Over.
Steel City with the effective penalty kill there. But this jam's going its full duration as neither jammer has lead at the moment.
That Philly pivot is just on Flux like nothing.
And Flux able to pick up 3 more points. That's an 11-0 jam for Steel City despite conceding the power jam. And they extend their lead to 161 to 134.
Yeah, 4.5 minutes left of the second half of this game. It has been such a good game. A lot of back and forth. The jammers, their beautiful footwork. And we got Zora and Rousey here. And there goes Rousey with lead.
So let's see if Rousey can get Philly back in contention here. She's got lead. Oh. Zora's still contained in the pack.
Rousey almost
Zora
made it on that outside.
The helmet line. Cover. And Zora is out. Rousey's on a scoring pass.
Let's see if Rousey calls it or lets it run a little bit.
Like, you know, Philly may not have a choice but to run this jam at this stage.
Ooh. Rousey snuck on that outside line on the other side of the track, picking up another 4, bringing her total to 8 already. Still a minute left in this jam.
And Rousey around already on a 3rd scoring pass, but Zora is out. She's picked up 4 points.
Okay. Penalty assessed to Rousey for a high block.
That's what that signal looked like. So Zora on the power jam for Steel City. I'm not sure how many points Rousey was able to pick up before incurring the penalty.
I don't know. Philly's got Zora down. It looks like they went ahead and went for that star pass, and now your jammer is Dakota slamming.
But she completes the scoring pass.
Well, I guess we'll see how many points Rousey got during before her penalty. And nice. Philly walking away with 12 points in that jam, and Steel City getting 10.
Good work there by Dakota slamming to, you know, to get some points on the board for Steel City.
Really took advantage of that power jam. Less than
2 minutes of the game. So Steph Leppard to jam against Tawanda Woman. This could possibly be the last jam of the game.
Very clustered pack. Steph trying to bounce through everybody.
Steph Leppard locked up at the front. Tawanda Woman spun out at the rear of the pack. Tripod of Steel City blockers holding strong on Steph Leppard.
Woo, makes it out with lead. Wanda's still fighting that pack, but makes it past that pivot, completing their initial pass.
Steph Leppard with the jammer star for Philly.
Makes it all the way. Tawanda being recycled back to the pack. And Steph Leppard calling it.
But Steel City able to collect 2 points. They have a 23-point lead going into what is likely the last game.
Yeah, it looks like a team timeout. Philly's KT going ahead and taking their last timeout. Try to recoup, see what they can do, what their plan is for this last jam.
So who?
I mean,
So who are we likely to see jamming for Philly? I'm thinking Rousey.
That's my guess. Is Rousey for Philly and Zora? It looks like Zora.
Is that? So there's Zora or maybe Flux.
Yeah. Let's see if we can pull this up here. Let's see, what number is that jammer? Can't see. We got 502 for Philly, which is.
I think that's Rousey back to the jammer line for.
Yeah, 902, Rousey.
Yeah.
I still wasn't able to see that number for the Steel City jammer.
Rousey jamming against Flux. Blockers backing into the jammers at the start. Flux trying to throw a block to contain Rousey. Rousey still fighting at the front of the pack. She gets lead. And the race is on for Philly. Steel City, a quick star pass.
Oh, see, they put Zora on the pivot.
Smart bit of play there by Steel City. But Rousey is out with lead. Zora has completed her initial.
Both just getting 4 points now. We're going to see if they're going to run the clock or what they're going to do. Like Zora hit a solid wall of Philly blockers there. And it's like Steel City like... put the brakes on Rousey.
Yeah, there's just got to be some tug of war between the packs right now.
Well, some offense from Philly there.
Zora trying to pry that tripod apart of Steel City blockers. Got Terminator locking down at the front.
Yeah.
Zora sent to the infield. 23 seconds left on the jam clock. Rousey bottled up in the pack.
Those Philly blockers not even caring about the obstacles. They're just going to move around and keep holding Zora. Oh, and there goes Rousey finishing up the game and the jam with an additional 4 points.
Zora collected four as well as an 8-8 jam to end the game. Steel City hangs on to win 181-158.
What a fun game. That was a good one.
Great game. That was a great game. Steel City, I mean, they're probably thinking about what happened last night. They just dug deep and held on to win this game, and they should be very happy with that.
Not again. Not only that, but Steel City, congratulations on taking the win of the Battle of the State, essentially. Yep. It was fun.
And the handshake line forms around the perimeter. Steel City, first through. A well-earned victory there for Steel City.
Everybody worked hard in that game. All of the blockers, all of the jammers.
Super hard.
A lot. Yeah.
And Philly taking their handshake lap as well. Are we going to get a London Bridge at the end?
Oh, Mike, are we going to get a bridge? You do it? No.
Not quite. Maybe not.